Today we're talking about stagflation, the definitive answer to the question, what's the worst thing that could happen? Now the basic idea here is a lot of inflation without growth, basically the hangover without the great night beforehand. Now the easiest way to think about this issue is to just picture yourself at a massive auction. First thing on the block, this pencil. I know, riveting content. Do I hear $5? $6? $7, going once, going twice, sold to the guy offering $6. Simple enough, we all know how an auction works here. But now let's start tinkering with things in the background. If you want to increase the value of the bids for this exact same pencil, how would you go about doing that? Well, the first and most common solution to the inflationary question is, just print a whole bunch of money and distribute it out. If you have a few $1,000, well, paying $7 for a pencil might sound entirely ridiculous. But if you're suddenly sitting on a few million, maybe I'll treat myself and spend an extra dollar for that same item. Millions of Americans suddenly treating themselves, and the prices are gonna start to rise a little bit. Now that would fulfill the inflation side of stagflation, but not the stag part. People spending more money on items means growth, and you're going to see the GDP continue to go up. Even if prices are going up, people are spending more. Inflation, not stagflation. So back to our auction house again. If we want to raise prices while shrinking consumption, gotta get creative with it. I know, I could set the starting bid at $7. Yeah, I know everyone thinks that this pencil should cost $6, but I got my own bills to pay and the cost of the components have gone up. You want to buy it for $6? Great, get a time machine and go back to when I could manufacture it for $5. We're going to have to start the bids at least $7. Now this is considered to be one of the main drivers of the textbook example of stagflation from back in the 1970s. The price of oil skyrocketed, so if you want to ship or manufacture something, well, it's gonna cost ya. Nixon simultaneously imposed import tariffs to protect domestic markets, which had the effect of raising prices further on imported goods. Things were getting more expensive, but not because people were demanding more and kicking up the prices. In fact, with those higher prices, people were buying less because everything's more expensive all of a sudden. This led to things simultaneously contracting and getting more expensive. Stagflation. The cost push inflation can also be seen looming in the background of today's markets. I mean, in the latest forever war for America just sort of forgot it's participating in, Joe Biden announced earlier this month that he's keeping most of Trump's tariffs in place on Chinese imports. Similarly, we're seeing a shortage in key components like microchips. So, even if we get the number of things on the shelves back up to the amount that are demanded by the consumers, each individual item will still be more expensive. The last potential cause of stagflation that most people focus on is quite a bit more short term. Going back to our auction house, you could tell bidders, well, you see this pencil right here? You might see it as a $6 pencil, but guess what? We don't have enough for everyone. If you want to be one of the bidders that ends up with one of these pencils, well, you better have deeper pockets than the next guy. Again, we'd end up selling fewer pencils and prices would go up. Now this last type of inflation, Bloomberg has coined as stagflation lite. The great flavor of terrible economic policies with none of the lasting impacts. Now a simple explanation of this happened to me a few years ago. You see, back during Hurricane Sandy, I was living in New York, and it wiped out all of the power and all of the ATMs. There were pretty much three food vendors to choose from, limited supply, and you weren't going to have access to fresh cash for some time, limited demand. So with scarce cash and scarce food, which market force won out? Well, prices skyrocketed on a lack of supply. People were paying $8 for the boiled street dogs made out of the meat deemed unfit for belts. And sure, consumption plummeted, but the prices spiked for what limited supply there was. Now, unlike a rise in fixed costs, this falls under the category of stagflation lite because the solution is to simply make more stuff. People want more than what we have, so sure, we'll increase prices in the short term and sell less, but in a few months we'll have enough to balance out the scales. The demand is there, we just need to fulfill it. Now, this more hint of stagflation inflation can be seen very clearly today. I mean, leave Los Angeles in charge of a port, and of course there's eventually going to be an offshore traffic jam. Hey, I've been looking for a parking spot for months over here. Now, with empty shelves and bow to stern traffic, a lack of supply can be seen pushing up prices. But unlike a classic case of stagflation, there is a pent-up demand being unsatisfied. It's not that less cargo is moving, in fact, ports are processing record levels of imports right now, and the costs of shipping containers have skyrocketed to unprecedented heights in recent months due to demand. The supply chain simply cannot keep pace with the elevated demand for goods, and industry players expect strain to persist. Unlike your classic cases of stagflation, the demand is there, we just need to make the supply and demand sides meet. So, why is any of this important? I mean, the house is on fire, let's figure out why later. Well, knowing the cause of the house fire could prevent you from pursuing a solution that causes further damage. Don't dump water on a grease fire, and don't pursue policies that make costs rise during a stagflation spell. The $1 million question, or let me just refresh that really quickly, the $1,002,000 question, sorry, inflation, is which of these forces is the primary driver of today's price increases? Stagflationary cost increases, stagflation light supply shortages, or just good old fashioned inflation from an increased demand? Now, unfortunately, that's like handing someone a jug of water and asking them to separate the drops from China and the drops from Colorado. All these forces are blended up in the same statistics and have their own unique effects on the system. Now, the Biden administration seems to have pegged the drivers of this bout of inflation on a supply issue coupled with an increase in the cost of underlying components. Now, that means that their solution is stocking the shelves as quickly as possible and lowering costs, rather than focusing on trimming down demand through a lack of spending. To that effect, Biden is pursuing a policy of pushing to open the ports for as long as he can possibly do it while pursuing increased spending across the board, whether it be a $250 billion bill designed to decrease the cost of core electronic parts, or the currently debated 3.5, 1.7, depends on which day you're looking at the news, dollar reconciliation bill. Now, I hope this clarifies our current potential stagflation conversation going on right now in America. And thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I'd like to thank my patrons over here for helping me put out my videos. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news looking into the overlooked, join this growing list of exceptional individuals by clicking on that link in the description. Also remember to subscribe and ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring. Give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw, and lastly, as always, thank you for watching.